Hello dear students, today we are going to see how to prepare the cocoa butter suppositories. So the aim for today's practical is how to prepare and submit cocoa butter suppositories. The requirements are apparatus, that is porcelain dish, glass rod, suppository bowl, water bath and spatula, and the chemicals are bismuth, subgalate, cocoa butter and liquid paraffin, which will be required for the lubrication. So suppository are solid or stiffened semi-solid dosage form meant for insertion into body cavities like rectum, vagina or urethral tract. They melt at body temperature or soften or disintegrate or dissolve in the body. So here you can see the suppositories which are meant to be inserted into the body cavities, and they are selected in such a way because they melt at the body temperature and slowly cause the release of the medicament. So types of suppositories: rectal suppositories, they weigh 2 gram and they are used to be inserted into the rectal cavity. Vaginal suppositories, which are also known as the pessaries, which weigh about 3 to 5 gram. And they are molded in globular or OV form shape, or they are compressed on a tablet press into a conical shape. Then urethral suppositories, which are called bogies, which are pencil shape. They are intended for males and weigh 4 gram each. And those for females, they weigh 2 gram each and 60 to 70 millimeter in length. Nasal suppositories, which are also called as nasal bogies or buginaria, which are meant for introduction into the nasal cavity, and they are prepared with glycerogelatin base. Ear cones, which are known as orinaria and meant for introduction into the ear, and they are rarely used. Theobroma oil is used as a base, and they are the mostly used in all types of suppositories. So now we'll see the advantages of suppositories, that is they can exert the local effect. Then they are used to prevent the evacuation of the bowel. It avoids any gastrointestinal irritation. They can be used for unconscious patient. They can be used for systemic absorption of drugs and avoid the first pass metabolism. Babies or old people can be given these suppositories. Post-operative people can also be given these suppositories. And people suffering from severe nausea or vomiting, the suppository is the best option. Disadvantages include the problem of patient acceptability. They are not suitable for patients suffering from diarrhea. In some cases, the total amount of drug must be given will be either too irritating or in greater amount. Incomplete absorption may occur in case of suppository. Characteristics of suppository base, which is the major thing in the preparation of suppository. First of all, it should melt at body temperature. It should be non-toxic and non-irritant, compatible with any medicament. Release any medicament readily. It should be easily molded and removed from the mold. Stable to heating above the melting point. Easy to handle, stable and storage. So types of suppository bases include fatty bases, which melt at body temperature, and water soluble or water miscible bases. That means they dissolve or disperse or dissolve in rectal secretion. So fatty bases, example is the most commonly used is the cocoa butter, which we are going to perform today. That is, it is a yellowish white solid with chocolate like odor. And it is a mixture of glycerol, ester, stearic, palmitic, oleic and fatty acid. Advantages is what? It melts at body temperature and it is readily melted on warming, rapid setting on cooling. It is miscible with many ingredients and non-irritating. Disadvantages include it exhibit polymorphism, adherence to the mold takes place, softening point too low for hot climates, melting point reduced by soluble ingredient, rancidity on storage, poor water absorbing ability, leakage from the body can take place, expensive. And other is the hydrophilic suppository base. The example is macrogols, which is known as polyethylene glycol and glycerogelatin base. Method of preparation. First method of preparation is hand rolling. It is the oldest and simplest method of suppository preparation, and it has the advantage of avoiding the necessity of heating the coca butter. A plastic-like mass is prepared by triturating the grated base, coca butter and active ingredients in mortar, and the mass is formed into a ball using the palm of the hands and then rolled to form a uniform cylinder with a large spatula or small flat board on a pile tile, and then the cylinder is cut into appropriate number of pieces which are rolled at one end to produce the conical shape. So effective hand rolling requires considerable practice and skill, otherwise the mold will not be formed properly. So here you can see hand rolling thing. You have to triturate it in mortar and then have to roll it with the help of hand to form a cylindrical structure. Then you have to cut it into the segments to form the suppository. Then comes the second one, that is the compression molding. It is used for preparing suppositories from a mixed mass of grated suppository base and medicament, which is forced into a special compression mold. It requires the capacity of the mold first be determined, and then active ingredient is added. It is necessary to omit a portion of the suppository base based on the density factor of the active ingredient. So a lot of calculation is required. Then comes the fusion molding, in which we have to melt the suppository base and then dispersing or dissolving the drug in the melted base. Then the mixture is removed from heat and poured into the suppository mold, and then when the mixture is congealed, the suppositories are removed from the mold. And the fusion method can be used for all types of suppositories. So today we are going to use this fusion molding method for forming the suppository base. Then this is one concept, that is the displacement value. Now what is this displacement value? It is the number of parts by weight of medicament which will displace the one part of weight of the base. So volume of a suppository in a particular mold is uniform, but its weight will vary because the densities of the medicament differ from the density of the base. And to prepare the products accurately, allowance must be made for the change in density of the mass due to added medicament. So the volume of suppository from a particular mold is uniform, but its weight will vary because of the densities of the medicament. So to prepare the products accurately, allowance must be made for the change in density of the mass due to the added medicaments. And the most convenient way to determine that is to use the displacement value. So first of all, you have to do the calibration of the mold. So how can you do it? That is, prepare and weigh 6 suppositories. So suppose that is a milligram, then the prepare and weigh 6 suppositories containing 40% of the medicament, that is the b milligram. So calculate the amount of theobroma oil c milligram and medicament d milligram in the 6 suppositories. So now A minus C milligram is equal to the weight of the theobroma oil, which is displaced by D milligram of the medicament. So displacement value, it can be given by D divided by A minus C. So for example, suppose the weight of 6 unmedicated suppositories is 6 milligram, and 6 suppositories contain 40% of the zinc oxide, so that is 8.8 grams. So theobroma oil in this will be 60 divided by 100 into 8.8, that will be 5.28, and the zinc oxide content will be 40%, so that will be 3.52 grams. Then theobroma oil displaced by 3.52 gram of zinc oxide will be 6 minus 5.28, which becomes 0.72 gram. So displacement value of zinc oxide will be 3.52 divided by 0.72 is equal to 5. So the displacement value of bismuth subgallate is 3, which means what? 1 milligram of theobroma oil is displaced by 3 milligram of bismuth subgallate. Ten suppositories, each containing 300 milligram of bismuth subgallate, are to be prepared. Therefore, total amount of medicament will be 10 into 300, that is 3000 milligram, that is 3 gram, and this displaced 1 gram of theobroma oil. Hence, the amount of base required will be 10 into 1 minus 1, that is 9 gram. So, total weight of suppositories will be 9 plus 3 is equal to 12. So what is the formula for suppositories? That is bismuth subgallate 300 milligram and coca butter quantity sufficient. So the role of ingredient is what? Bismuth subgallate, it is astringent, and coca butter is base. So how these quantities came, that you will come to know in the video where I am explaining the calculations. So now we will see how to calculate these values and how to perform the or how to prepare the suppositories.
Hello dear students, today we are going to prepare and submit coca butter suppositories, that is 2 quantity. The formula for this is bismuth subgallate 300 milligram, which acts as an astringent, and coca butter, which acts as a base, that is quantity sufficient. So depends on the capacity of the mold. So if you are taking 1 gram of a capacity mold, then as per that you have to do the calculations. The category for this is, it is used for the treatment of hemorrhoids. So the category of the suppository is astringent. Now we will see how we will calculate the calibration value. So calibration value, it is calculated. For this calculation, first we have to do is the calibration of moles. And based on the calibration of moles, we get this calibration value. So, total weight of 4 suppositories obtained after calibration or after the freezing was 3.6 grams. So, average weight of one suppository will be 3.6 divided by 4, that is 0.9 grams. So, the calibration value of this mold carrying the, 1 gram capacity, the calibration value for that particular coca butter suppository was found to be 0.9 grams. Now, we will see the calculations for the displacement value. The number of suppositories, okay, so we are going to prepare 2 suppositories, but we are taking the weight as per the 4 suppositories to avoid the errors during the performing the practical. So always we take two suppositories in excess as compared to the actual suppositories. Okay, so number of suppositories is 4. Calibration value, as we have calculated, it is 0.9. okay, then base required will be how much, it is given by the formula L into CV, that is number of suppositories into calibration value, so that becomes 3.6 gram. After that, what is the weight of the drug required for the suppository? So for one suppository I require 300 milligrams. So for four suppositories I will require 300 into 4, that is 1.2 gram. okay, so what is the actual weight displaced? That will be equal to weight of the drug divided by displacement value. So 1.2, and the displacement value for this particular drug is 3, so that will become 0.4. okay, so this is the amount, or you can say amount of base that will be displaced by this particular drug. Okay, so weight of base in actual, how much it will require? That is the required base minus displaced base. Okay, so how much is required? That is the 3.6, and how much it will displace? That is 1.2 gram of the drug will displace the base by 0.4. So the actual weight of base required is 3.2. okay, so working formula will be weight of base plus weight of drug, that is weight of base is how much, 3.2 plus 1.4. so whenever you are going to perform the practical of this suppository, you will have to take 3.2 gram of the base, that is the coca butter, and 1.2 gram of your drug, that is bisphenol subcalate, and perform the practical. Okay, so this was all about the calculations for the coca butter suppository. Now we will see the how to perform the procedure. Now we will perform the practical, but before that we will see the requirements. So requirement for this practical are, that is this is the drug bismuth subgalate, then coca butter which will act as a base, then this is the petri dish, glass rod, suppository mold whose calibration has already been done, and I have shown you the calculations, that is 0.9 gram capacity, then lighter, then liquid paraffin which will be required for the lubrication of the mold, spatula, and this is the cotton which will be required for the lubrication. So very first we will see how to do the procedure. So first of all, we will perform the lubrication of this mold. So I am opening this mold, and here you can see the molds are open. Now care should be taken that these molds are completely cleaned. Okay, now I will lubricate this using this liquid paraffin. Okay, so I have taken this liquid paraffin, and now I am taking this cotton, and with the help of this cotton I will lubricate the molds. Lubrication should be done properly, and proper lubrication is required so that the suppositories will eject smoothly, otherwise they can get sticked and we will not get the appropriate suppositories. So that is the reason why this step is very important for proper ejection of your suppositories. So I have lubricated this. The tip should be lubricated properly, Otherwise, the entire suppository get ejected, but only the tip remains into the mold. So this should be kept in mind. Similarly, I am lubricating the second mold. Now this is completely lubricated. Now I will place these molds aside. And now I will proceed for the preparation. Now I will first of all take this cocoa butter base. As per the calculations, I require 3.2 gram. So I have taken this cocoa butter base and now I will melt it. And then I will add the bismuth subgallate. I am melting this base. You can see the base is melting. Slowly. Now the base is completely melted. Now I will add the drug, that is the bismuth subgallate. So here you can see I have taken this 1.2 gram of bismuth subgallate. I am going to add this into this base. And mix it properly. Now bismuth subgallate has been completely solubilized in the base. Now I will pour this melted base into the suppository mold. Now I am pouring this in suppository mold. This suppository mold is well lubricated and tightly bound. Otherwise, whatever is the fluid, it will move out. So now I have poured this both the cavities with this suppository melted base, and here you can see I have overfilled these cavities because after congealing the cocoa butter base it gets contracted. So always keep in mind that your whatever is this fluid or molten base which contains the drug, that should be filled in this cavity in such a way that they are overfilled. So even after congealing, your suppositories will not be deficient because of the excess of the base I have added. The weight will be appropriate. Okay, now I will place these suppositories in refrigerator for congealing. Now I am placing this in refrigerator for congealing. Now the suppositories are congealed. Now we will scrape off this excess of the material which is there with the help of the spatula.
and now we will remove it. So here you can see the two suppositories are obtained. Now I will remove it slowly. So likewise here you can see I have got the two suppositories. Now I will wrap it in butter paper. Now wrap individual suppositories in butter paper as per your requirement. So my suppositories are wrapped. Now I will place this in suitable container and label it and dispense it.
So I hope you have understood the procedure. So quickly we'll see the procedure. Shred and melt the coca butter. Calculate the calibration value of that particular mold. Then triturate the drug with coca butter and melt it to produce pourable mass. Then you have to lubricate the mold using liquid paraffin. Fill the lubricated mold and keep it for congealing. So that is all about the procedure. And after congealing, just remove it, eject it and wrap it. Category and use. It is used for the treatment of hemorrhoids. Dose is one at night and one in the morning after the bowel evacuation. Storage condition. Storage container is wrap individual suppository and place in screw cap jars in a cool place, and you have to protect it from light. Labeling instructions include for rectal use only and remove the wrapping before insertion. So label include, that is the category and use, what is the dose, what is the storage container, direction, remove the wrapping before insertion only. And for rectal use only. Okay, you have to place it in cool place, otherwise the suppositories will melt. And prepared by whatever is the manufacturing thing. So we have prepared two coca butter suppositories. So the result is coca butter suppositories were prepared and submitted. Question bank. Define suppositories, write advantages and disadvantages of suppositories, explain calculation of displacement value, and also they can ask you the calculation of calibration value, explain method of preparation of suppositories, enlist and explain various types of suppositories, then what is the role of ingredient in the suppositories. Okay, all these questions they can ask, or we can ask you question on what are the types of suppository bases, or write a note on coca butter base. So thank you students for listening. This was all about how to prepare and submit the coca butter suppositories. Thank you students.